Hey guys, it's Ryan back here again, and today we're reviewing Star Wars Rebels Mission Series, Visago, and IGRM. This 2-pack is part of Wave 2, and the retail price is $9.99. Up first, let's take a look at Visago, who's the current equivalent of Hondo in the Rebels TV series. Unfortunately, we haven't seen much of him yet, but hopefully that changes soon, because he's got a really good character design, and I actually like the voice actor behind him too. This Devorian has a bulky stature, and he's wearing your typical smuggler's attire too. Sculpt-wise, he looks great, and they finished it off with some excellent paint applications as usual, for both his skin, as well as his clothing too. His head sculpt is not too shabby too, with some painted sideburns, an angry facial expression, red painted eyes, and even a broken horn. And you'll also notice, sculpted into his ears is some earrings. On his torso as well as his shoulders, he's wearing some gray body armor, while the shoulder plates per se are painted darker than the rest. Underneath all that, he's wearing a white shirt, and painted onto the left shoulder is a yellow emblem. He's wearing some gray gloves, with white straps underneath at the wrists. Sculpted onto the belt is a buckle that's painted in gold, as well as a couple small pouches too. Strapped to his right thigh is a holster, where he can display his blaster pistol, and his boots are painted in matching dark gray. The articulation for Visago includes a swivel head, which is a little bit limited due to the shoulder plates, as well as swivel shoulders and swivel hips. And his weapons and accessories include a bronze blaster pistol. Moving on to the second and final figure is IGRM, one of Visago's multiple bodyguard droids. The design for these droids is actually based off the original MacQuarie concept for IG-88, so it may look a little familiar to you, because Hasbro actually made a figure based off that concept art. When it comes to the fine sculpt details, the figure's a lot less limited in that aspect, but the paint applications are nice and crisp, especially the yellow accent details that are throughout the entire figure, which work really well for the overall light brown base color. The head sculpt is quite unique, and it mirrors the MacQuarie concept almost identically. The yellow accents do continue onto the head, there's also some white markings for lights, and the eyes which are sunken in are painted in black. On the torso is where most of the yellow accents are, and they have some pretty crazy designs too. And they also line up on the upper legs. The limbs are quite thin, especially the arms, but they're made out of sturdy plastic so they're more than likely not going to warp. The hands are quite detailed, with individually sculpted fingers. Sculpted onto the back of the torso is a power panel. Throughout the figure is various panels and seam lines, since it is a droid after all. And the feet are even arched at their centers. IGRM doesn't come with any weapons or accessories, but its articulation includes a swivel head, swivel shoulders, and swivel hips, which are a little limited due to the thigh plates. Overall, for about $10, these characters may not be that relevant in the story yet, but they do add some nice variety to your Rebels collection. The figures are perfect in both their paint and sculpt work, with my only complaint being the limited articulation as usual. IGRM could have used some accessories, but that's something that can be easily corrected, especially if you have some spare accessories just laying around. So, if you're a Rebels fan, I'd definitely consider you pick this one up. I hope you all enjoyed this review, and I look forward to seeing you in the next one.
Subscribe for hundreds of collectible reviews, including Halo and Star Wars, and follow me on Facebook and Twitter for up-to-date channel news.